Thank you, God in heaven, for this day, which we confess as the day that you, the Lord our God, have made, a day that we will rejoice and be glad in. We are grateful. We want to thank you, God, for the Nigerian Society of Engineers and for their great history and contributions to the development of our country in Nigeria. We thank you for their collaboration with other countries of the world. You have used them to build our cities, our towns, even our villages and rural places. Their contributions are invaluable. And we are grateful because you have been with them. The Bible says, unless the Lord builds the house, the builder labors in vain. So we are grateful because their labor has not been in vain. I want to thank you for the past leaders of this society, how you have been with them. And we are grateful that today we are gathered for the inauguration, commissioning of a new leader. O Lord our God, we pray that as a new leadership takes over the Nigerian Society of Engineers, it shall be a leadership with great vision, a leadership with great courage, and innovative leadership, a contributory leadership. We pray, O Lord our God, that by the time the new president, who is the 31st president of this society, will be leaving office, he will leave the office better than he met it, in Jesus' name. And we know that on his own he cannot do it, and therefore we are asking that you will grant him wisdom, you will give him good health, you will grant him your favor. O Lord our God, in our various societies of the world, we have problem of leadership. We pray that here in the Nigerian Society of Engineers, it shall be leadership with a difference. It shall be a compassionate leadership. It shall be an inclusive leadership. It shall be a patriarchal leadership. It shall not be a fragmented leadership or a segmented leadership. Oh Lord, we pray for Engineer Adekunle Mokolu that you will fill him with your spirit, the spirit of wisdom. And oh Lord our God, we pray that through him, there will be unity in the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Even people who have been discouraged about the society, now that he has come on board, we pray you grant him that favor, that they will all join hands to build this nation. The Nigerian Society of Engineers is a body to promote development and the unity of this nation. Oh Lord, we pray that as a new leader comes in, what eyes have not seen, and what ears have not heard of, and what things have not come to the thought of people about engineering in Nigeria, will be established from on high in Jesus' name. So we thank you for this program that has started. You have commenced with us. May you continue with us, and may you complete the program for us, so that when we will look back to this day, we will have reasons to continue to glorify you. Bless Engineer Mokolu, bless members of his family, bless all relations here, bless all colleagues, bless all friends. Thank you for bringing Engineer Chief Baba Olusegun Obasanjo here. May you bless him as well. Other leaders, political leaders that are here, may you bless them in abundance. Let this program, O Lord our God, be a huge success. And let every life here be greatly blessed. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen. Thank you very much. We are going to have the Muslim prayer by Dr. Kabir Hamed, Imam from the National Mosque, Abuja.
You may be seated, please. Sallu ala Nabi al-Kareem, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the name of Allah, the beneficent, the merciful. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator and sustainer of the world. O Allah, we thank you for this day as we stand here before you to crown the new leadership for the Nigerian Society of Engineers. O Allah, guide them, protect them, give them the wisdom to continue with the good work as far as engineering exercise is concerned here in Nigeria and beyond. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I welcome you all to this memorable event of the ceremonial investiture of the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. History has been made today that will move engineering in Nigeria to the next level with the theme, Engineering Infrastructure for Unity and Progress in Nigeria. Let's put our hands together for ourselves that we're here this morning. I would like to recognize the presence of the special guest of honor, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, FNSC GCFR, ably represented by the Honorable Minister of Science and Technology, His Excellency Dr. Ogbonnaya Onu, FNSC. I would like to recognize the presence of the former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Engineer Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, FNSC GCFR. I would like to recognize the presence of His Excellency, the Governor of Ogun State, Chief Ibukunle Amosu, FCA, ably represented by the Deputy Governor of the State, Chief Mrs. Yetunde Ononuga. I'd like to recognize the presence of the Honorable Minister, Federal Capital Territory, Alhaji Muhammad Bello, ably represented by the Executive Secretary, FCDA, Engineer UG Jibril, FNSC OON. I would like to recognize the presence of the Honorable Minister of Water Resources, Engineer Sulaiman Adamu, FNSA. I would like to recognize the presence of the Senate Committee Chair on Works, Senator Dr. Architect Kabiru Gaya, Vice President Interparliamentary Union African Group, who is also representing the Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Please can we put the hands together for him, please. I would like to recognize the reason why we're here this morning. The 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Olumuiwa Mukolu, FNSE, and his lovely wife, Dekiness Abosede Oluyemisi Mukolu, and their children, please. Please, can you rise up for recognition, the children? I would like to recognize the presence of the Deputy President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Mohammed Babagana, FNSC, and his lovely wife, Ajia Aisha Babagana. I would like to recognize the presence of the Vice President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Tasil Gadiri Wudil, FNSA. I'd like to recognize the presence of the Vice President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Joseph Olatunde Akinteye, FNSA, and his lovely wife. I'd like to recognize the presence of another Vice President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Dr. Mrs. Edith Ishidi, FNSA, and our lovely spouse. I would like to recognize the presence of the National Exco member of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adeniran Felix Ibitoyi, FNSA. National Exco member, Engineer Mrs. Alimat Adeniran. I would like to recognize another National Exco member, Engineer Yakubu Ali Garba, FNSA. National Exco member, Engineer Professor Tony Abdurrahim, FNSA. National Exco member, Engineer Mrs. Chinyere Nena Iwigwe. National Exco member, Engineer Dr. Abdurrashid Babalola. And it gives me great pleasure to recognize the presence of the immediate past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers and his lovely spouse, Engineer Otis Oliver Anyeji, FNSC, FAENG.
I'd like to recognize this morning past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer I.K. Inua, OFR, FNSC. I'd also like to recognize this morning the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Dr. F.A. Shonubi, FNSC. I'd also like to recognize the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Vincent Maduka, FNSC, OFR. I'd also like to recognize this morning the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Dr. O. Ajayi, FNSC. He's here with his amiable spouse. Can we put our hands together for her, please? Thank you. I'd also like to recognize this morning the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he is Engineer Dr. E.J.S. Ujamaa, FNSC. He's also here with his beautiful wife. I'd like also like to recognize this morning another past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he's Engineer Charles Mbane for FNSC. He's here with his beautiful wife. Thank you very much. I'd also like to recognize this morning the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he is Engineer Habu Gomel, FNSC. I'd also like to recognize this morning the presence of a past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers and the current president of the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, and he's Engineer Kashim A. Ali, FNSC, NPOM, MNI. I'd also like to recognize this morning the past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he's Engineer Olumuyiwa A. Ajibola, FNSC. Can we put our hands together for him, please? Thank you. I'd also like to recognize another past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he's Engineer Mustafa B. Shehu, FNSC. He's here with his amiable wife. You're welcome. I'd also like to very warmly welcome a past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers as well, and he's Engineer Isaac Ademola Olorunfemi, FNSC. I'd also like to recognize this morning the former governor of Ogun State, His Excellency Engineer Otumba Gbenga Daniel, FNSC, CON. I'd also like to recognize with us this morning Engineer Senator Iola Omisore, FNSC. I'd also like to very warmly welcome this morning Engineer Senator Adefemi Kila, FNSC. I'd also like to welcome this morning Engineer Honorable Iboro Ekandem, MNSC, Member, House of Representatives. I'd also like to recognize with us this morning the presence of Engineer Nuruddin Abdulrahman Rafindadi, FNSC, the MD of FEMA. Can we put our hands together for him, please?
It gives me great pleasure this morning to recognize the presence of the Managing Director, Transmission Company of Nigeria, Mr. Usman Mohammed. I would like to recognize the presence of the Deputy Managing Director, TCN, Engineer Dr. Abubakar Atiku, FNSA. I would like to recognize the presence of the President of the Baptist Boys High School, Abeokuta Old Boys Association, Professor Ajao Adelekan. I would like to recognize the presence of the wife of the Deputy Governor of Delta State, Engineer Mrs. Ebere Otuaro, FNSA. I would like to recognize the presence of His Royal Highness, the Emir of Kano, ably represented by Alhaji Shehu Muhammad, Sakin Shannon of Kano. Please, can you be upstanding for recognition, please? I would like to recognize the presence of the Emir of Kauzare, His Royal Highness, Alhaji Najim Hussein Adamo. I would like to recognize the presence of the former head of service of the Federation, Engineer Mrs. Ebele Okeke, FNSA. I would like to recognize the presence of the chairman, Innoxon Group of Companies, ably represented by Mr. Kenneth Chamberlain. I would like to recognize the presence of the President, Court of Appeal, ably represented by Justice Emmanuel Ajim. I would like to recognize the presence of the President, Association of Professional Bodies of Nigeria, Dr. Idris Omede, FNMA. I would like to recognize the presence of the President of the Nigerian Academy of Engineering and Pioneer President of the Association of Professional Women Engineers of Nigeria, Engineer Mrs. Olu Joan Maduka, FNSE, FAENG, MFR. I would like to recognize the presence of the President Ghana Institution of Engineers, Engineer Mrs. Kalin Boachid. She's leading the delegates of all engineers from Ghana. Please, can you be upstanding for recognition? All the delegates from Ghana, please. Thank you very much. Thank you. I would like to recognize the presence of the President of the Association for Consulting Engineering of Nigeria, Engineer Charles Akindayomi, FNSE. I would like to recognize the House Committee Chairman on Sport, Honorable Goni Buka. Please, can I be upstanding for recognition, please?
In line with the theme for this year's investiture, which is Engineering Infrastructure for Unity and Progress in Nigeria, ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome students of Christabel Private School for a brief drama presentation.
Thank you. Warm greetings to you, Your Excellency. Warm greetings to you, Your Excellencies, Your Excellency President Buhari of the Federal Nigeria, former Chief Obasanjo, Your Excellency Alake of Igbaland, please permit me to stand on all protocols. Distinguished guests, and my name is Joshua. My name is Joshua Oyeyemi. We Christabel Private School from Wuye District, Abuja, have a presentation titled Engineering for Unity and Progress in Nigeria. Our presentation comprises speech, drama, and poetry. Please enjoy. Thank you.
My warmest greetings to you, Your Excellencies, President Buhari of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, former President Obasanjo, Your Excellencies, Alake of Igbaland, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Akan Jesse. My schoolmates and I are from Christabel Private School, located in Wuye District, Abuja. We are here on this special occasion to congratulate our school patron, Engineer Adekunle Olumuyiwa Okanbimokunu, the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Congratulations to you, sir. We, Christabel Private School, are every bit proud of you, school patron. We are confident and praised under your tenure as President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Nigerian engineers will have professional and mental invigoration like we have never seen before. We are confident you will help nurse and coordinate their untapped creativity, capability, and resourcefulness. Under your tenure, we believe, we are confident and pray there will be exacting, uncompromising standard and code of ethics to produce top quality engineering by our own engineers who will continue and triple their efforts in building infrastructure in our cities, towns, and rural communities across the country. Congratulations, school patron of Christabel, the 71st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. We pray you have divine strength and power beyond what is normal and every day. Now we have a dream. Thank you.
I have a dream to see engineers in rural communities across the land. I have a dream to see a resident engineer in every significant rural community, district, local government area, you name it. A resident engineer, yes, a resident engineer who helps to engineer the building of schools, hospitals, roads, housing units, pipe-borne water, and so on. A dream, a vision to see an average countryside locality have functional social amenities built using local raw materials where feasible. I have a dream to see a resident engineer working with the local government council, the village chief and elders, and the local polytechnic or university. A dream for engineering by Nigerians in the rural communities. Thank you.
I have a dream for Nigerian in Udana local government area, a lack of clear-cut building practices for some states in the southeast, northwest, and south. Nonetheless, there are solutions. What building practices have worked in rural America? How has this water supply problem been solved in rural Japan? And how did the authorities of rural China come about with this local technology? I have a dream to see the situation at the headquarters of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, working with the resident engineers in Akoko and Udana local government areas and other areas. I have a dream for engineering in rural Nigeria. Thank you.
I have a dream for engineering in rural Nigeria. How do you feel? Local needs, local manpower and raw materials in synergistic blend with proven practices in rural communities around the world. A situation room of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, a beehive of activities, is in constant link up with resident engineers in rural areas and elsewhere. Behold a new dawn of engineering in rural Nigeria. Thank you. Now, the play. Please enjoy. Thank you. Now, the poetry. Please enjoy. Thank you.
We can do it! We Nigerian engineers, we do understand the depth and scale of the challenge. We accept the heavy responsibility that comes with it being engineers. We have therefore signed up to uncompromising best practices. We Nigerian engineers can do it. Thank you.
So, if you demand excellence from us, we Nigerian engineers, that's okay. If you insist on strict compliance with the highest standard, we are on the same page. Your expectation. Your unwavering, non-negotiable expectation is our unflinching dedication. We, Nigerian Society of Engineers, can do it. We, Crystal Private School from Wuyeh District, Abuja, give our best wishes to our school patron, the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Olumiwa Okonbi Mokolu, whose lovely, diligent wife is Mrs. Abosede Oluyemisi Aduke Mokolu, the MD/CEO of Christopher Private School. Since health is indeed wealth, and all the good life offers, good health to you, Your Excellencies, President Muhammadu Buhari of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, former President Obasanjo, our royal fathers, please allow me to stand on existing protocol. Good health to you, distinguished dignitaries and guests. Good health to you, our great Nigerian engineers.
Good health to the Mokolus. Good health to you, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, just so I don't forget, good health to Christopher Private School. Thank you.
Hey, come. Are you done?
Put our hands together for the pupils of Christopher Private School.
Thank you. You're a superstar. Superstar. Well done.
I would like to recognize the presence of Vice President, World Federation of Engineering Organization, former President, Association of Professional Women Engineers of Nigeria, Engineer Mrs. Valerie Agbiragba, FNSA. Please, can you be upstanding for recognition? I would like to recognize all the chairmen of divisions of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Please, can you be upstanding for recognition? All divisional chairmen of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. You're welcome. I would like to quickly recognize the presence of all branch chairmen of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Please, can you be upstanding for recognition, please? All branch chairmen of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I would like to also quickly recognize the all fellows of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. All fellows of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Thank you very much. Let's have our seats as I invite to the podium Engineer Otis Oliver Anyeg, FNSC, FAENG for the welcome address. Please, let's put our hands together for him as he comes to give the welcome address for the ceremony. Thank you.
The President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari GCFR, ably represented by His Excellency Engineer Dr. Obonaya Ono, FNSC, FAENG. Permit me also to revert to Mr. President himself that he too is FNSC. So, His Excellency Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, FNSC. Engineer Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, FNSC, GCFR, PhD. That is a PhD that was earned by sweat and study. FAENG also, the President of the Senate, hereby represented by His Excellency Architect Kabiru Gaya, FNIA, the President Council for Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, Past President, Engineer Kashim Ali, FNSC, MNI, MPOM. Let me stop there. The Deputy Governor of Ogun State, Well, I will still get the name and revert to that and do it more thoroughly. Our past presidents here present, Engineer Khalil Inua, Engineer Dr. Folashodu Shonubi, Engineer Vincent I. Maluka, OFR, Engineer Dr. Olusegun Ajayi, Engineer Dr. EJS Ujamaa, Engineer Olumuyiwa Alade Ajibola, FNSE, FAN, Engineer MB Shehu, Vice President of Federation of African Engineering Organizations, Engineer Ademola Isaac or Lauren Femi, I'm also one of the past presidents here present. The Honorable Minister of Water Resources, our Royal Fathers here present, His Royal Majesty the Emir of Kazaure, have the representative of the Emir of Kano, Her Excellency, the Deputy Governor, the wife of the Deputy Governor of Delta State, Engineer Mrs. Otuaro, the Emeritus Head of Service, Engineer Ebele Okeke, the Deputy Governor of Ogun State, Her Excellency Chief Yetunde Onanuga, fellows and members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, members of the family of the brand new president of NSE that have come from all over the world, friends of engineers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I make my remarks as outgone president for 2016-2017. I actually noticed on the program for yesterday's colloquium that the organizers were still very partial to me and referring to me as outgoing. Well, even as at that time, I was a substantive, outgone president of the society. And very soon, when I generously relieved myself of the burden of this chain, my successor will also become outgoing. And his deputy and our president-elect will then become incoming. A very long labor. To produce a human being, it takes just 9 months. But to produce our president, the labor for the society is 2 whole years. I greet you all, beautiful and lovely people that have congregated here to keep Nigerian engineering company. And this is happening as my successor in office, Engineer Adekunle Olumuyiwa Mokuolu, Akombi is there too, FNSC, is being invested with paraphernalia of office as president of the great and honorable the Nigerian Society of Engineers. The title of my remarks is Evident Truths of Our Profession. And this has been chosen to enable one to lay bare some of the fundamental issues that change and progress for our profession depend on. First, I have to return to the topic of my presidential address, Missing Link in Nigeria's Development, Insufficient Engineers in the Policy Space. And it is still true that there are not enough engineers as ministers, ministers of state, permanent secretaries, chairmen of relevant committees in the National Assembly, even as there are 11 engineer distinguished senators and over 15 engineer honorable members. Sorry for the break in transmission. My iPad just switched off, and I was more than prepared for it. As things stand, the Nigerian state would benefit from a study of the models for ministerial selection in the United States, where they have 225 ministers, that is, secretaries, deputy secretaries, assistant secretaries, and undersecretaries. And all these are screened and cleared by the US Senate. And also the United Kingdom, where they have over 100 ministers, secretaries of state who are in charge, ministers, parliamentary secretaries, junior ministers. We need to learn to regard the constitutional stipulation of one minister per state as a minimum, and then determining the policy elements packages of ministries would help determine the optimal number of ministries and ministers. Secondly, a few days ago, discussions on the council platform were on the issue of who is the chief executive officer of the society. Happily, on the NSC website, the section on structure and leadership says the president is the chief executive and directs the program and mandate of the society on behalf of members. I may only add here that the president as the CEO is responsible also for strategic direction and overall supervision of all functions. The executive secretary is like a chief operating officer, responsible for day-to-day execution. And this then takes us to the third truth of our profession, that in a professional engineering organization or professional engineering institution, strategic planning rules, not the personality of a president. In giving strategic direction to the society, the president has the responsibility of making sure the society is doing the right thing at the right time and must continue to formulate workable strategic game plan that puts the society in a position to consistently perform well. The fourth truth is that following from our president's function to reflect upon and evaluate things in terms of their impact upon the whole society, to discern what decisions and actions are best from the standpoint of the entire engineering professions, there is continuing need for advocacy. Some of the issues that will not go away soon include promotion of Nigerian content, renovation of engineering curriculum and faculties, engineering regulation and legislations, steady workload for Nigerian engineering firms, proper placement of engineers as heads of engineering-based agencies, and so on. Only a few days ago, engineer ST Kolo posted information on the Fellows platform on China completing the world's longest sea bridge. Engineer Solomon Owaifo, FNSC, commented inter alia, Nigerian engineers are in jail in Nigeria. This is the fifth truth, that state regulation of a profession is akin to imprisoning of such professionals in that country. State regulation imprisons innovativeness, it jails creativity, and places economic development in detention. Engineer Owaifo pointed out that engineers have to be free to dream and not before. Incidentally, President Vincent Maduka, OFR, a little while ago pointed the way to engineers being liberated from this jail, Owaifo wrote about. And paraphrasing Engineer Maduka, we hear charter status for the profession and regulation of engineering, and he says, I believe the UK arrangement is chartered, A. B. ICAN in Nigeria is chartered, and I reckon they are not answerable to any ministry or minister. They are self-regulated, like all mature bodies and professions. These are the words of Engineer Past President Vincent Maduka, OFR. Past President Maduka hit the nail on the head with this sixth truth. Let us pay attention to his and Engineer Waifo's words. And these two of our colleagues are in their 80s. Self-regulation or charter recognizes the maturity of a profession and respects and honors the special skills, knowledge, and experience that a profession possesses. When a profession is chartered or self-regulating, it means that the government has delegated its regulatory functions to those who have the specialized knowledge necessary to get the job done. Another truth I came about recently through Professor P.B. Kwale, one of our oldest electrical engineering professors. And he says, any civilization is certainly destroyed if it comes in contact and remains in romance with corruption, violence, and sectionalism. This seventh truth is very valid for us, as both engineering and the Nigerian Society of Engineers are civilizations. And I believe that we will all continue to choose to avoid these trinities of evil. Physical infrastructure. Some of the modest achievements that were recorded during my tenure 2016-2017 include installation of one 450 kg six-passenger lift at the auditorium conference complex through surplus from donations made from my investiture in 2016. We have also continued to drive for promises that we have made that have not been received. We continue receiving those donations even in 2017. Tiling of the external walls of auditorium and tower, which has given the National Engineering Center a unique and distinguished facade in the central business area or this business district. We also, from donations made to support the president's project fully furnished the auditorium, the gallery, and the meeting rooms in that complex. We also have been able to provide solar lighting around the auditorium to check attempted pilfering and stealing that we saw was threatening. Other milestones that we achieved in the development of the profession, we recognized quite early that there ought to be strategic planning that will lead the profession. And we have, in the last 2 years, been able to get the President of the Federal Republic to nominate an engineer to be chairman of the Nigerian Electricity Regulatory Commission, the first time since that commission was established. Two other engineers were also nominated as commissioners, following the petitions we addressed to Mr. President. We also addressed similar petitions to the Minister of Petroleum, and that led to the appointment of an engineer as the principal of PTI, the first time in 25 years for that to happen. In structural changes, as I said earlier, we reverted the NSC management system to change from functional support areas focus to engineering professional-based areas for effectiveness. In legislative activism, we stepped up advocacy to maintain a presence at the National Assembly in such a way that for the first time, the Senate introduced the practice of establishing a technical committee after they have come up with a bill. And the committee was set up after the third reading and was chaired by a fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. At many of such bills, the technical committees were chaired by our members. We have tried to address the nature of engineering organization in Nigeria. We have challenged the dichotomy between CORIN and NSC. We have been promoting the establishment of one apex body to be an engineering council, and we combine the functions of professional association and the regulatory agency, as previously highlighted, advised by Engineer V.I. Maluka. The way we have the ICAN for those accounting profession and NIM for those of management. We have been arguing that we have these two engineering bodies merging as one apex body that will cater for the genuine development of engineering in Nigeria and for the establishment of a technological base for Nigeria. We have tried to do all these things to achieve a kind of stable foundation that will take whatever is going to be built on it subsequently. And we believe that all that we have done is but just a foundation. And I have strong belief that the 31st president and his team, of which I am still a part, will do even much more than we have been able to do in these 2 years. In fact, on this note, I cannot wait to just unburden myself of this chain that looks gold, but is not quite gold. I'm saying so that, I mean, those, the walls have ears. Those who will be pursuing the 31st president thinking that if they get this thing, they are made. It is not so. It just looks beautiful. I thank you all for coming. I actually have seen that I didn't recognize my colleagues from Ghana, and that is serious. I mean, being the president of the West African Federation of Engineering Organizations, I ought to have remembered them first. But I think we can rationalize that as saving the best for last. And so, let me please once again ask my colleagues from Ghana Institution of Engineers to please be on standing for another round of applause for you. Mr. President, what next do I do? You are the custodian of the, is it agenda or the program? Do I come down and come up again? Can you afford to wait? You're already there. Okay. So thank you all and God bless you all.
Can we appreciate him a bit more, please? Thank you very much, the immediate past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I'd like to quickly take a few recognitions. I'd like to recognize the presence of Engineer Professor Peter Onwelu, FNSC FAS. He's representing the National President of Nigerian Academy of Science. I'd also like to recognize the Deputy President of the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, and he is Engineer Professor E.A. Ajav. I'd also like to recognize the country representative of the Institution of Civil Engineers, UK, and he's Engineer Larry Ajuya. He's ably represented by Engineer AOT Oyelola. Can we put our hands together for him, please? I'd also like to recognize builder Kenneth Nnabuife, FNIOB. He's the president of the Nigerian Institute of Builders. And lastly, I'd like to recognize Engineer Kamila W. Maliki, FNSC MNI. He's the registrar of the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria. A round of applause for him, please. To deliver the keynote address, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, with a resounding round of applause, please help me welcome the representative of the Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and he is Senator Dr. Kabiru Aigaya. He's the Vice President of the Inter-Parliamentary Union African Group and the Chairman, Senate Committee on Works. Your hands together for him, please, as he comes up. Thank you. If you don't have a seat in the hall, please go to the galleria upstairs. We have enough seats there for you. Thank you.
That was a long shot on this matter. I would like to, before I go on the protocol, I would like to commend the students of Christabel's private school for their wonderful performance. It looks like President Engineer Adekunle, you are trying to produce another engineer, president of the NSC from the school. Congratulations for that. President Muhammadu Buhari, who is ably presented by the Honorable Minister of Science and Technology, President Obasanjo, a great leader, a great man, a president who is still playing squash. But I was told there are rules for playing squash with him. And I agree with you, Mr. President. Thank you, sir. President, I don't want to say outgoing, but you're still outgoing. You're still the president now. Maybe in the next few minutes you should be former president. And then the incoming president, Engineer Kule, who I've been interacting with and is under, with the committee or the organization is with, under the Committee of Works. I'm here to present, all other protocols in the traditional rulers. who are here, the Emir of Kazauri, who was also the former secretary of PTF, where all consultants, I'm sure you can agree with me, were really utilized during those time. I was also a consultant at that time. I'm here to represent the Senate President. He's unavoidably absent, he's out of the country, and he asked me to deliver his speech. So I read. It is my honor to be at this auspicious gathering to witness and celebrate a new milestone in the career of true icon and professionals in his field by way of inaugurating Engineer Adekunle Makolu, FNIC, the present as the 31st president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Indeed, the Nigerian Society of Engineers makes an invaluable contribution to the creation and implementation of policies guiding the development of rural and urban projects in Nigeria, as well as nurturing experts in safely sustaining the sector into the future. I congratulate the NSC on the successful conduct of the election that produced a new 13-member national executive for which the esteemed engineer Makolu now sits at the apex as the 31st president. The emergence of the new president could not have come at a better time than now. The downturn in the economic affairs of the country having ramifications for almost all spheres and sectors has been a major challenge and obstacle to delivering the stated objectives of government. This has at times constituted an impediment to the productiveness, value addition, and sustenance in many sectors. Happily, the worst is over. Our recovering economy presents us with new opportunities to make maximum impact in our various spheres, opportunities we must grab with both hands. And I'm confident that the NSC will play its part with very capable hands of Engineer Makolu at the helm of the affairs. My abiding interest in rural and urban development projects has availed me for some of the problems and challenges faced in the sector. The average developer or investor wants to cut the total cost of development to an appreciable sum. The unscrupulous ones will seek to achieve this by either reducing the quality of the material or by employing a service less qualified practitioner for otherwise high-level technical projects. Some will even seek to bypass the regulatory agencies in a bid to scrimp on cost. What you get as a result are structures that fail to meet the standard of national guidelines and which cannot stand the test of time, and that's why we have collapsed structures in pounds on parts of this country. This must be avoided. This poses a major risk to us all, and eradication must form part of the preview of your agenda as you assume this mantle of leadership. I call on you and your esteemed organization to help prepare cost-effective solutions toward achieving the best global standards on projects, employing the least bureaucratic measures possible. The stamping out of sharp practice and the cutting of red tapes should help along the way in meeting our infrastructure challenges, and I assure you that the 8th National Assembly stands ready and always to support the achievement to this noble, as well as the advisory body. These are all areas in which I believe we have a meeting of minds with shared values that should help propel the sector forward as an economy gathers pace. On our own part in the National Assembly and in line with our agenda for the 8th Senate, we are always geared toward the development of laws and initiatives that favor human, capital, and structural development. We are for laws that take necessary steps to address national economic challenges, infrastructure decline and decay, wastages, leakages, and bureaucracy. This is why plans are underway to examine and build on recorded success of the Nigerian Content Development Monitoring Board, NCDMB, even as we work to stimulate the same in the engineering and infrastructure sector. with a view to improving local participation. We also have the local content bill, which also increases or determines the use of Nigerian engineers and other professionals, but yet the law is not practiced. We find that in some areas that you have engineers which are not even as good as Nigerian engineers, but are brought to site from foreign countries, which we have to regulate that. I think, Engineer Kasim, you have a lot to do. I could say that recently we had a standing bill of Federal Road Authority bill for over 40 years. The government wanted to do this bill, but luckily enough, I sponsored this bill in the Senate with the road fund, and the bill will be passed in the next few days, as soon as we resume. Finally, let me use this opportunity to once more congratulate the 31st President on this great achievement, and to also commend the Executive Committee and members of the National Society of Engineers, NSC, for putting up this grand event, which I wish you a successful tenure, and may God continue to guide you and bless you in this new endeavor. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Thank you very much. I would like to quickly recognize Engineer Professor Aruna Muhammad, FNSC, Executive Vice Chairman Naseni. Please can you be upstanding for recognition? I would also like to appreciate the gentlemen of the press. Please can you put your hands together for the gentlemen of the press? Thank you so much for doing a good job. Your Excellencies, fellows, corporate members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, invited guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we have been waiting for. The investiture of the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I would like to invite the 31st President, Engineer Adekunle Olumuyiwa Mukolu, FNSC, to be on stage. While I invite Engineer Professor Ademola Adesa Bello, FNSC, to read the citation of the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Please, let's put our hands together for him as it comes. Beside every successful man, there is always a very supportive wife. Please, can we have on stage the spouse of our 31st President, Deaconess Abosede Oluyemesi Mukolu, on stage.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the protocols for this event has been set, but you will permit me to please recognize the presence here of the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, ably represented by our very own His Excellency, Engineer Dr. Ogbonnaya Onu, Fellow, Nigerian Society of Engineers. Permit me also to recognize the former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, our very own Engineer Dr. Olusegun Obasanjo, FNSC. My lords, spiritual and temporal, past presidents of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, fellows and members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and importantly, the members of the 4th Estate of the REM, without whom all we are doing today will end up in this room. The 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Olumuyiwa Mwakolu, fellow Nigerian Society of Engineers, was born in Mercy Hospital in Lagos on the 1st of June 1954 to Mr. John Adedako Mwakolu and Mrs. Christiana Mwakolu, both of blessed memory. May God bless their souls. Engineer Mwakolu and his younger brother, Mr. Adewale Mwakolu, however, spent their early years in Ibadan, where their paternal grandmother, Madame Osuntolu Mwakolu, also of blessed memory, may God bless her soul, as both parents left them in her care to pursue their studies in the United Kingdom. Engineer Mwakolu, no doubt, enjoyed great liberty during the period of stay with his grandmother because of the usual affection of a grandmother. Engineer Mwakolu was therefore not scolded by anyone for whatever reason. He was his own master at that time. However, this freedom was cut short as soon as the parents returned from UK. In 1966, our 31st president obtained his first school leaving certificate with distinction at Ibadan City Council Primary School. Here, he met a teacher who was called Mrs. Florence Adesowo Desalu, who painstakingly taught him arithmetic then in primary three. It is a credit of Mrs. Desalu, whose method of teaching arose his interest in the study of this crucial subject and later the science subjects generally. Mrs. Desalu inspired Engineer Mwakolu in no small measure in the direction of paying attention to his studies. Engineer Mwakolu's father spent great interest or special interest in his education and was committed to guiding him appropriately. He therefore enrolled him at the Baptist Boys High School, Abeokuta, believing that the institution was suitable to equip his son fully for excellence and his higher educational pursuit and complement sound moral. His father's intention was to guide him to become a chartered accountant in the hope that he would succeed him to take over management of the family firm Mwakolu, Robbins and Co., auditors and chartered accountants. Engineer Mwakolu became very brave, conscious of the vibrant at school in all ramifications in 1971, left Baptist High School Abeokuta for a co-boys high school, Mushin, to finish up his secondary education. Here he bagged the General Certificate of Education in Division 2 in 1972. Engineer Mwakolu later secured admission at the Federal School of Arts and Science, Lagos, where he successfully passed his higher school certificate, which is popularly known as the HSC, in 1976. This therefore paved way for him to enter the Faculty of Engineering in the University of Lagos. The student's work experience, also referred to as SIWES, which is part of engineering degree program, then enabled Engineer Mwakolu to acquire a wide range of experiences. While under the tutelage of Engineer Babatunde Lakwite, fellow Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Mwakolu had the rare opportunity to travel to Leeds in the United Kingdom, where he spent 6 months in continuation of the SIWE scheme, which started earlier in Enugu. The development of infrastructure at Leeds Municipal ignited Engineer Mokolu's dream of impacting his own country, given the opportunity someday. From that point, young Mokolu continued to envision how rural areas in Nigeria can be developed by the provision of basic amenities. I guess that was what informed the colloquium which took place in this very same hall yesterday. Engineer Mokolu returned back to Nigeria and completed his program at UNILAG, where he bagged the Bachelor's of Science degree in Civil Engineering in 1980. He then proceeded to Cross River State in 1981 for his mandatory NYSC. His primary assignment was at Ogoja Waterworks. Engineer Mokolu was mentored there by an experienced top official by the name Mr. Fidelis Ushaka, who made his stint at the waterworks very memorable. Engineer Mokolu seized the opportunity of the national service and garnered a lot of skills from the artisans, the technologists, and the technicians that were attached to the plant. These experiences came to bear later in his career. After returning home at the end of his NYC scheme, Engineer Mokolu had to quickly leave home in view of the immense pressure from his father to reconsider delving into accounting and auditing to take over the management of the family farm. His career. At the time, engineers were in high demand by the federal government to execute the building of new federal capital territory in Abuja. Mokolu then took his destiny into his hands and moved into Abuja. By the grace of God, he secured an appointment with the Federal Capital Territory Development. This unique appointment provided the platform for Engineer Mokolu to prove his mettle in service of fatherland. In 1988, he was posted to supervise rural development projects, and then the opportunity came for him to make the impact that he longed for as a student way back in the UK. His service at the Federal Capital Development Authority between 1981 and December 2009 was characterized by so many projects. Prominent among them are the works he did on supervision and construction of engineering infrastructure to the Northwest District, Wuse 1 District, executed by Mrs. Julius Berger Nigeria Limited. Supervision of construction of A2 Ashara Dangara Yaba Road, including 185-meter span bridge over the Gurara River, executed by Mrs. Dantata Nsao Construction Nigeria Limited. He became the desk officer for PTF projects between 1995 and 1996. He also supervised the construction of engineering infrastructure to Idu Industrial Area in Abuja Municipal Area Council. This was executed by Salini Nigeria Limited between 2003 and 2004. He also participated in the design and construction of Jikoyi Karshi Road as a dual carriageway. Construction of electricity supply reticulation to villages in the FCT. Design of engineering infrastructure to satellite towns of Peigi, Gidamangoro, Wasa, Galuyi, Sheri in FCT. He was also the coordinator and supervisor of activities of two sections in the Regional Roads Division of Department of Satellite Town Infrastructure, which is in the FCDA, between 2008 and 2009. During the years of service at the FCDA, Engineer Mokulu was privileged to work on several projects, including some that were of much interest to the ministers of the Federal Capital Territory at different times. One of such occasions, he worked on projects that were intended to ameliorate the plight of FCD residents who suffered the unfortunate demolition exercise during the administration of His Excellency Malam Nasser El Rufai, now the Executive Governor of Kaduna State. In spite of the transparent execution of projects, soon after the government change, the EFCC invited Engineer Mokulu and detained him. There were pressures from notable individuals who induced him to give false witness against the then minister. Even with the accompanying intimidations, Engineer Mokulu maintained his integrity and refused to falsely indict the former minister. Further investigations later revealed that Engineer Mokulu displayed prudence by undertaking all projects allotted to him in the most cost-effective manner. He was therefore released by the EFCC. This message I just delivered, I am told, the executive governor of Kaduna State never got to know. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Engineer Mokulu became the first engineer to voluntarily retire from FCDA at the rank of deputy director, essentially to practice engineering and not to venture into politics. The services of our 31st president to the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Engineer Mokulu is a life member of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. As a life member, he holds the number 02349. And as current registered engineer, he holds the number R.02732. He was conferred with fellowship of the society in the year 2000 and a fellow of the Nigerian Institution of Civil Engineers in 2003. He is also a member of the American Society of Civil Engineers and also a World Bank certified public-private partnership professional. Some of his services, some of the services to the society and the profession include, but not limited to, a few of the following I'll mention. From 1985, when the Abuja branch became registered by the Executive Council of NSC, he has served the Executive Council in so many levels, culminating in him becoming the chairman, a position he held for 6 years. At the national level, Engineer Mokulu was a member of the Executive Council between 1990 and 2001, and 2008 to 2010. Within this time, he was chairman editorial board of the newsletter, he was editor of the Nigerian Engineer, an NSC professional interview with the Abuja Center, and served as a member and sometimes chairman of many boards at various times, most of which include revision of the 30 years ahead for NSC, conference planning, publicity, membership, constitution review, welfare, first technology summit, investment and properties, finance and general purpose. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the 31st president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers has a record of being elected 5 times vice president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. 2008, 2009, 2010, 2013, and 2014, before the audience and general members of NSC felt dimmed to elect him as Deputy President and President in Waiting in 2015. His awards are so numerous, I will mention just a few. He had the Presidential Merit Award in 1992 and 1993, Distinguished Service Award, Abuja Branch 2003, Ambassadorial Award, Abuja Branch 2009, and Professional Merit Award of the Nigerian Institution of Civil Engineers in 2009. Faith and Family, I'm happy at least we've seen that by faith in Christ and in Christ alone, and his life according, and lives his life according to the word of God. Deaconess Oluwayemisi Makolu, she is a nurse and an educationist. Their marriage is blessed with so many children. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, you will agree with me that the election of Engineer Makolu is no doubt an authentication of the confidence of members of the society in his ability and capabilities as a thoroughbred, business-minded technocrat. He has earned his reputation in his sterling performance and selfless service to his professional body and the nation. Your Excellencies, special guests of honor, distinguished guests of honor, my lords, spiritual and temporal, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a complete gentleman, a man dedicated to selfless service and mentorship, a man who by his track record will provide purposeful leadership that will take our society, the Nigerian Society of Engineers, to a higher altitude. I am therefore honored to present the 31st president of our noble society, the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Olumuyiwa Makolu, Fellow, Nigerian Society of Engineers. Can you go ahead?
For the oath taking and investiture, ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome up to the stage the immediate past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and he is Engineer Otis Oliver Anyeji, FNSC. Your hands together for him as he comes up, please. Thank you.
The President, Nigerian Society of Engineers, the President and Commander-in-Chief, the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the past President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, all other protocols duly observed. I was just having some family issues, discussion with the what do we call you at this point? Okay, President. And before then, I got an instruction from the president of Corin that he was going to score my performance if I don't shape up. And I promised him that I was going to rectify certain things. And one of them, of course, is the inexcusable situation of not having acknowledged my better half, my beautiful and amiable Dame Nkechi Anyeji. My wife, my best friend, my confidant. Who has been with me through thick and thin, all through this journey, right from when I started the journey in the Executive Assistant Secretary General in 1988. So may I publicly acknowledge all that support and thank you, my love, for what you have been to me, what you have done for me, especially as my chief advisor. Once I had issues to take on in engineering, all I needed to do is to explain it to her. And when I explain it to her, I am sure of the best advice. When also many people didn't feel so free to come to talk to me, but they felt freer talking to her. And once those issues got there, she will continue to press that those issues are addressed and will continue to ask after that. I thank you, my love. You're sweet. I love you. And thanks to the president of CORIN too. Isn't this lovely? Beautiful. And diverse, you know? I think that we will continue to thank God for this family, the beauty they radiate, the industry and resourcefulness, and the diversity they showcase, you know, to us. God bless you. Eh? Beautiful. We go ahead. Sorry for the break in transmission, but I realized that if I just remove this chain, I will be no longer relevant here. So we have to sort things out properly. You know, we expected Mr. President at the conference. And we were to present a copy of the Nigerian Infrastructure Report Card to him. And Mr. President is here. So we'll just take a short time to present our second Infrastructure Report Card to Mr. President. So, Mr. President, if it is in the village, they say, I'm not asking you to go on a message, but Mr. President, if you can step forward so that we can hand over these copies of the Nigerian Infrastructure Report Card for 2017, where we have depicted the state of the infrastructure in Nigeria, you know, the federal assets. And we hope this will assist in the actual preparation of budgets for remediation of the defects that have been identified. Actually, we went worse than we were in 2015, but I wouldn't speak the figures here, but it's encapsulated there. So, Mr. President, it gives me great pleasure to hand over copies of this infrastructure report card to you, and the 31st president will be following closely, because he already would have started preparing for the next one after this, and he had promised that, in fact, as he's going to all these rural areas, he will also make sure that the infrastructures there, their states, will be added to the next edition. So thank you, Mr. President. Is there any other thing I'm expected to do as president? Huh? No. I'm not. You know, the president of Corinth told me some. I don't know if any other person has any other thing. Not when I come down now, you say that I didn't do this, I didn't do that. Thank you. The president, Nigerian Society of Engineers. President and CNC, it is now my singular privilege and great honor to conduct the investiture of the 31st president of our great and honorable the Nigerian Society of Engineers, today, the 13th day of January in the year of our Lord 2018. Mr. President, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu, I respectfully request you to just one step forward, because I wouldn't.
Great privilege and honor for me to present this compendium of the minutes of executive committee and council meetings that you presided over to you. I hope you will find them useful in your future endeavors. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. President.
His Excellency, Distinguished Senator Kabiru Gaya, Fellow of Nigerian Institute of Architects. The Honorable Minister of the Federal Capital Territory, represented by our own, a good friend and a brother, Engineer Yuji Jibrin, FNSC, OON, the Executive Secretary of Federal Capital Development Authority. The Honorable Minister of Water Resources, Engineer Suleiman Adamu, FNSC, my Oga, I recognize you. The President of the Association of Professional Bodies of Nigeria, Dr. Omede, Fellow of Nigerian Medical Association, the Deputy President of the Nigerian Center of Engineers, Engineer Muhammad Babagana, FNSC, and his amiable wife, the Vice President, Engineer Tasiu Gadiri Udil, FNSC, the Vice President, of the Nigerian Center of Engineers, Engineer Joseph Olatunde Akintaye, FNSC, Vice President, Nigerian Center of Engineers, Engineer Dr. Mrs. Edith Ishidi, FNSC, the ESCO members, Engineer Adeniran Felix Ibitoye, FNSC, Engineer Mrs. Halimat Adediran, MNSC, Engineer Yakubu Ali Garba, FNSC, Engineer Professor Abdulbaki Abdurrahim, FNSC, Engineer Mrs. Chinyere Nena Igwebe, MNSC, Engineer Dr. Abdul Rashid Babalola, MNSC. My immediate past president, my friend, Engineer Otis Anyeji, FNSC, FANG. The past president of the Nigerian Center of Engineers present here, Engineer Ike Inua, OFR, FNSC. Engineer Dr. F.A. Shonubi, FNSC. Engineer Vincent Maduka and his amiable wife. Engineer Mrs. Olu Maduka, FNSC, FANG, the president of Nigeria Academy of Engineering. Engineer Dr. O. Ajayi and his amiable wife, FNSC. Engineer Dr. E.J.S. Ujama, FNSC and his amiable wife. Engineer Habu Gumel, FNSC, O.N. Engineer Kazim A. Ali, FNSC, MNI, and President of Council for Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, Koren. Engineer Olumuyiwa Alade Ajibola, FNSC. Engineer Mustafa B. Shehu, FNSC, and his amiable wife. Engineer Isaac Ademola Olorunfemi, FNSC. The Fellow of Nigerian Center of Engineers, our own distinguished Senator Iyola Omishore, FNSC, Engineer Senator Adefemi Kila, FNSC, the Royal Fathers of the day, like to recognize the representative of Emir of Kano, Alhaji Shehu Muhammad Sarikin Shanu of Kano. And I'd like to also recognize my own senior, very, very senior Oga, the Emir of Kazauri, a barrister. I almost called him engineer. His Royal Highness Adamu, all other protocols, I want to stand on them, but then I would like to recognize very specially the international delegates, and particularly the Ghana representatives of the Ghana Institute of Engineers, led by the President, Engineer Mrs. Kalem, fellows of our great and noble Nigerian Center of Engineers, members of the Nigerian Center of Engineers, distinguished guests, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, Please pardon me if I've made any errors in this protocol. I'm just trying to learn to be the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. My inaugural speech. I thank God Almighty, the Father of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, for making me to see this day, and for his grace and mercy that has given me this uncommon opportunity to serve this great, noble, and honorable society, the Nigerian Society of Engineers, as president. I thank all members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers for electing me in 2015, the deputy president of our society, by your strong will and determination to ensure that I, today, receive the mantle of leadership to lead you for the next 2 years in such a manner that shall take our society to a higher level. I thank my loving and wonderful parents, late Mr. John Adedapo Mokolu and late Mrs. Christiana Olatundu Mokolu, for their tenacity to instill in me the values of life that have continued to be an album of inspiration to me. My father, who was a chartered accountant and a chartered banker of both England and Nigeria, and my beloved mother, who was a chartered secretary, are the most honest people I've ever met in my life. Their lives were devoid of hypocrisy. I am eternally grateful to my beautiful, loving, and adorable wife, Abosede Oluyemisi Mokolu, for her love and support for me in all ramifications, particularly in prayers for my success in every undertaking positive endeavors. My beloved and excellent children that God blessed me with have been great sources of happiness to me and are my very enthusiastic cheerleaders. I'm grateful to God always for having them behind me. I also thank my teachers at various levels of my education, to my extended family members' education. I'm also grateful to my teachers at various levels of my education for assisting me to be an engineer. My heartfelt appreciation to my extended family members, my friends, professional colleagues, and associates for your encouragement and unflinching support over these years. My royal fathers, particularly the Emir of Kazauri, indeed, during my stint with you over 25 years ago, you were really a person of sterling qualities. And so, and with all the other royal fathers, I thank you sincerely for your prayers and good thoughts towards me. I enjoyed so much love from you. Thank you very much, my royal fathers. I'm also grateful to the distinguished guest of honor, His Excellency, former President and Commander-in-Chief, Federal Republic of Nigeria, Engineer Dr. Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, PhD, FNSC, GCFR, for his support, prayers, and encouragement to never give up on any good cause. Babami, thank you so much for the courage that you have given me. I'm as bold as a lion now. Finally, I appreciate especially the special guest of honor, His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari, Honorary Fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, GCFR, for his unflinching support for Nigerian engineers and great commitment to the development of Nigeria by Nigerians. You all here have left more important engagements and traveled from far places to attend this occasion. May God reward you abundantly for the different roles that you have played in my life. The journey that brought us to this point started in 1976 at the Engineering Faculty of the University of Lagos, when the erudite professor of mechanical engineering and a doctor of science of the prestigious Imperial College London, with a patent of Rolls-Royce parts under his belt, engineer Professor Ayodele Awojobi, came into the year two engineering class for the first time and said the following, and I quote, "If you take away from my body everything that has the touch of a foreigner, I will be naked. If you take away from my house everything that has the touch of a foreigner, I will have to live under a roof and walls made from the trees and soil around my house. You are in this class to change all that for me and all Nigerians without reinventing the wheel. So be serious with your studies." End of quote. I received the booster to be a professional engineer when Engineer Babatunde Lakute, FNLC, the then associate partner of Alistair McCowan and Associates in Lagos, facilitated my working at the firm's headquarters in Leeds, England, for my 6 months supervised industrial work experience in my fourth year. The passion and determination to be strongly committed to the development of Nigeria was further kindled when the great Nigerian musician, late Fela Anikula Kokuti, released a music album titled Suffering and Smiling. Over these last 41 years, I have scored myself low against the remarks of my professor and the observations of my musician. On many occasions, I had always thought that I and some others should be agents of accelerated improvement in the provision of engineering infrastructure facilities for better life for all Nigerians. According to the great scientist Isaac Newton, in his first law of motion that says, everything continues in a state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless an impressed force acts upon it. End of quote. The impressed force for the development of infrastructure in Nigeria is the Nigerian engineer. That was the reason I have, over the years, maintained my mission statement thus, and I quote, to make the Nigerian Society of Engineers the platform for development strategies that will ensure Nigerian engineers are major stakeholders in delivering elements and structures of better life for all Nigerians. Today, we are celebrating the beginning of this mission. The theme around which my leadership of our great society will be built around is engineering infrastructure for unity and progress in Nigeria. Any visitor to our country observing the way the physical development of Nigeria is being executed cannot but ask the questions, where are the Nigerian engineers? The engineer is to ensure that our physical development is properly structured so that they are sustainable and respond efficiently to the use for which they are procured. Engineering infrastructure is an instrument of unity. Therefore, effective immediately, every local government and state government is advised to start preparation of master plan for its villages, towns and cities. These plans should be in accordance with the various town planning, architectural and engineering codes and standards. The Nigerian Society of Engineers shall partner with government to fight corruption. Nigerians are not corrupt. Few engage in acts of corruption because the system they are operating induce corruption at all levels and make integrity a personal choice to operate between the shades of white and black. Living in different shades of gray is very stressful and makes permanent solution to any development or societal problems unpredictable. In view of our political history, we must be patient with ourselves. It is very challenging for a nation to be colonized and after a short while to be ruled by her military. The progress of democratic system of governance is very slow and fraught with banana peels. The beauty and dividend of democracy is not provision of houses, roads, and other amenities for living, but the right of all citizens to be ruled by a common law and exercise the right to choose political leaders. The leaders so choose to then imbibe the attitude stated by the late Chief Obafemi Awolowo. I quote, "A truly public-spirited person should accept public office not for what he can get for himself, such as profit and glamour of office, but for the opportunity which it offers him of serving his people to the best of his ability by promoting their welfare and happiness." End of quote. I call on all members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers to be courageous. It is cowardice to fail to admit wrongdoings or negligence and refuse to change. It is cowardice to refuse to come to the light for self-appraisal of the extent of any filth and take appropriate action for cleanup. It is important for us to know that we can never innovate in darkness. We must therefore blow the whistle on ourselves whenever it is necessary, wash our dirty linens whenever it is necessary. We may have to wash them in public if need be. The important thing is that our linen is clean. The public will forget the smell in a short time as they enjoy our actions of care and kindness under respect for regulation and enforcement of engineering codes and standards underpinned by engineers' code of ethics. It is when we improve our built environment that we could say that we have lived on this part of the earth at a particular time. I hereby make a passionate appeal to all Nigerians, particularly our political leaders, to immediately join hands with Nigerian Society of Engineers and Nigerians engineers to develop our country and ensure that we provide first-class public facilities with all infrastructure, with an infrastructure that will be the envy of other countries. It is very clear that the present procurement process will continue to lead us to more troubles and increased infrastructure deficit. Let us start by thinking that we have no other place to go or settle in but Nigeria. We are together locked in this beautiful land called Nigeria. The absence and inadequacy of infrastructure facilities have led to so many Nigerians fleeing our country at the risk of their lives through the Sahara Desert and the Mediterranean Sea. According to a report in the Punch newspapers of September 13, 2017, about 10,000 Nigerians lost their lives between January and May 2017 while trying to escape to Europe, and a host of others have been sold as slaves in other countries. It is time for the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to declare a state of emergency on infrastructure. We must stop the attitude of come on. We must stop the attitude of come one, come all invitations to foreigners to execute contracts for our developmental projects. These developmental projects that are funded from our Commonwealth in taxes and levies. The Nigerian engineers are smart professionals. We make better lives and make better things since nothing is in its final state. We can determine who to invite from abroad for a particular expertise whenever the need arises. On this line of reasoning, I am particularly delighted that Nigerian engineers have strong affinity with our own honorary fellow of Nigerian Society of Engineers and President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR. In his speech at the Society Conference in 2009, I quote him verbally, "I personally believe that the development aspirations of any country cannot be achieved without first developing and subsequently utilizing its human capital. Great countries have been made great by their engineers. Think of Great Britain. It is Brunel, Sir Christopher Wren, and George Stephenson, all great engineers who stand out as prominent builders of Britain. But great countries always provide an enabling environment for their professionals to practice, encouraging them to stretch their dreams and imaginations to whatever limit, forgiving them of their errors, which in turn become subjects of exhaustive inquiry towards attaining future perfection. From such endeavors emerge national standards, indigenous technological solutions, and professional excellence." End of quote. What a poignant remark. The Nigerian Society of Engineers shall ensure the success of all the President's initiative in the direction of the above aspiration. I call on all other professional bodies to join the Nigerian Society of Engineers to partner with President Muhammadu Buhari to bring lasting and sustainable development to our dear country. Moreover, I call on all Nigerians to resolve to be law-abiding and shun all acts of violence and militancy so that government can apply savings from internal security expenses to provision of infrastructure for our common enjoyment. Today, we can build a great and beautiful nation that will attract the world. I hope in the year 2038, Nigeria shall submit an application to host the Olympics. It is possible. In my programs, the first is mentoring. Under my administration, the Nigerian Society of Engineers shall engage in programs that will rapidly produce more engineers. We shall engage the primary school pupils in pep talks to educate them on right attitude to common shared infrastructure facilities. There will be increased interaction with secondary school pupils on the values that engineers deliver in the built environment, starting from provision of weather stations in each school. Special attention will be given to our girls to encourage them to pursue career in engineering and ensure that the program Women in Engineering flourishes. After all, it's a wine thing. I actually borrowed that from the Ghanaians, from the Ghana Institute of Engineering. The women call themselves, it's a wine thing, and that helps to make sure that women get more interested in the practice of engineering. NSC shall also be committed to engineering students in the universities. We shall ensure supervised academic training with introduction of engineering students' logbook, which will be examined every quarter of the year by a mentor from the Nigerian Center of Engineers. Furthermore, our level of interaction with Industrial Training Fund and all engineering faculties will be increased and rejigged through technology to ensure a first-class supervised industrial work experience scheme for engineering students. We shall introduce competitions in engineering and technology innovations among students in the first quarter of 2018 and facilitate a seamless connection between the academia and the industry. Finally, we shall establish a scheme that will ensure that every engineering graduate has taken a one-hour flight and visited the highest point in Nigeria to enhance their thinking in three dimensions. None shall graduate in engineering totally on terra firma. The graduates will be put through a supervised pupillage during the National Youth Service Scheme and the Supervised Industrial Training Scheme on Engineering, CITSE, in collaboration with the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria. Logbook and mentorship shall be standard instruments of training of our graduate engineers. The graduate engineers shall work with us in Nigeria yesterday. This event has propelled us to commence a program tagged Community Engineering. The rural people can say, and rightly and truthfully, that they have contributed to the well-being of Nigerians much more than those living in our urban areas. Those of us in the towns and cities can only say at the end of the day that we have been neglecting those feeding us while engaging in stressful pleasures. Make no mistake, the smell from our villages is the smell of life, with production of food and fresh vegetables. In contrast, the smell from our cities is the smell of fumes from our generators and inefficient solid and liquid waste management. So, going back to the rural areas is the way forward. This will assist us to start proper planning of our land for development so that the facilities provided will be the sources of comfort and enjoyment to us. Every megacity started from being called city. Every city was once called a town, and every town was once called a village. The way forward, therefore, is going back. Let us start from the village and build outwards and expand to a beautifully planned, energy efficient, and environmentally conducive town, city, and megacity. The time to start is urgently now. Therefore, in a few weeks from now, we shall launch a pilot rural development scheme in collaboration with Association of Local Government of Nigeria, ALGON, and the various branches of the NSC across Nigeria shall drive this. 6 villages from each geopolitical zone will be selected for intervention. We plan to provide the infrastructure free for these villagers, and the cost will be borne by you and I. Please help the Nigerian Center of Engineers to help these rural people who have helped us with their sweat capital at various farm lots. My administration will strive within the first year to expand the frontiers of our branch network beyond the shores of Nigeria few international branches will be inaugurated with the aspiration of harnessing the abundant intellectual resources of Nigerian engineers in the diaspora. This will not only give Nigerian professionals a sense of belonging, it will broaden the scope of engineering expertise with broad range of experiences at the disposal of both the federal and state governments of Nigeria. Over the years, I took interest in the activity of a body called BACSAN, the Building and Construction Skilled Artisans Association of Nigeria. Theirs have been a lone voice in the wilderness for many years, yearning for attention in their advocacy for enforcement of standards and safety in construction sites in Nigeria, especially as their members suffer the worst fatality when accidents occur at construction sites. In pursuit of our mission of eradicating quackery in the built industry and thereby eliminating cases of building collapse, we have found BACSAN a worthy partner to achieve this goal. Okay, they are there. Therefore, the Nigerian Society of Engineers will deepen the provisions in the Memorandum of Understanding with BACSAN towards ensuring that the relevant codes and standards with appropriate ethics are adhered to in construction sites. In conclusion, again, I thank all members of the great and noble Nigerian Society of Engineers for electing me your president. In addition to the oath of office I have just taken, I promise to lead you with all sense of humility, dedication, accountability, probity, and transparency. I shall make every effort to restore the powers and dignity of council. I am now a man in authority. And I must subject myself to the authority of distinguished council members to enjoy my office. Power without control is tyranny, and control without power is anarchy. So rest assured for a blissful time with me. I appeal to all our members to pay their subscriptions promptly so that the welfare benefits of my administration could reach them. I plead with all members to show respect to each other. Let us own engineering and enjoy it. For fellows of our noble society, I say Nigeria needs you now. The recent economic downturn and glaring collapse of all elements of engineering infrastructure and economic development indices beckons on you to remind engineers you have trained and mentored at their various stages of their professional development that going back is the way forward. Going back to the constant values of integrity, probity, and strict adherence to ethics of engineering profession. Also, your institutional memory should be deployed to bolting down your legacies through improved interaction with the younger generation of engineers. It is very difficult to point to any development in Nigeria that was not handled by one of the fellows of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. So the challenge now is that you must ensure improvement of your various achievements by those coming behind you. May God help you so to do. I shall continue the strong participation of the Nigerian Society of Engineers with West African Federation of Engineering Organization, Federation of African Engineering Organization, and the World Federation of Engineering Organizations. Let us arise and build our country. Let us work hard to develop our country. And by the grace of God, we shall succeed. Other nations may laugh at us now, but very soon, and very, very soon, they shall laugh with us. Welcome to a great change. Long live the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Long live the Federal Republic of Nigeria. I love you all. Thank you for your attention, and God bless you all.
Please, let's put our hands together for the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers.
Thank you very much. Please be seated. First, I must apologize that I didn't know my speech is as long as this. But I hope there is something to take away. It is my singular delight, honor, and privilege to now inaugurate the wonderful executive that the great and noble members of the Nigerian Society of Engineers have given me. I did not choose them. They chose them for me. But I want to assure you that from the first executive committee meeting that was held 2 days ago, Nigerian engineers, I thank you for giving me this executive. Thank you very much. So, because of time, I'll just call all members of the executive to come, including the immediate past president, for me to inaugurate you. Now, I have powers over my friend, my senior engineer, Otis Tabugo Ayeji. Please, can you come to the stage to be inaugurated? We have members, more copies, there are more copies. Where is the roving mic? Before I do this inauguration, Your Excellencies, please permit me to do a damage control for the first blunder of my presidency. I forgot to recognize past president, engineer Charles Aniwetan Banefo, FNSC, and his amiable wife. My apologies, please. You're welcome, sir. Distinguished executive members, you are charged with the responsibility of overseeing the management and administration of the society's affairs in the next 1 year, in accordance with Article 31 and 34, subclause 4, of the Articles of Association of our great society, the Nigerian Society of Engineers. On this gracious moment, in the presence of all gathered here, I urge you to declare your commitment.
I, Engineer Babagana Mohammed, do solemnly affirm that I shall,
Congratulations, distinguished executive members, for accepting the responsibility to manage and pilot the affairs of our great society in the next 1 year. May God's blessings be with you and guide you to be exemplary leaders in the days to come. God bless you all. Congratulations once again. Now come and take the presidential handshake, and then you go back to your seat. Your Excellency, the special guest of honor, please permit me to now invite the distinguished guest of honor, Engineer Dr. Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, to please come to the podium here so as to give out the special this pledge to the special awardees. As president, I decided to give some awards today, first to appreciate those who have done so much for me. So we'll do that quickly, and then to showcase Nigerian engineers who have performed wonders in this country, so that government will know that what they are looking for in Sokoto is inside their Sokoto. The first person I'll call is the person that taught me in 1963. Arithmetic and English. I went looking for her, and I was so happy that she's still alive. God kept her alive at Ibadan. And that person is Mrs. Florence Adesemo Desalu. I saw her last 50 something years ago. I think she's in this hall. Can you come with your grandchildren? Thank you, Mama.
As a young lady that time, she was so beautiful. And I think she's still so beautiful. Please let her come to the stage.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers. Special Presidential Award presented to Mrs. Florence Adesewu Desalu for contribution to excellent education in Nigeria. Madam, you are honored.
Thank you very much. The next person is my mentor, Engineer Babatunde Olakute, FNSC. This award, like I said, that was like it was said in my citation, this man loved, he loves mentoring people, and he taught me the value of mentorship, and we'll get to that very soon.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers, Special Presidential Award presented to Engineer Babatunde Olakute FNSE for contribution to engineers' education, engineers' mentoring, and engineering excellence. Congratulations. I did feel like I'm going low.
Thank you very much. The next person is Mr. Fidelis Abomaye Mshaka. Mr. Fidelis Abomaye Mshaka, wonderful man. I served NYC under him when he was manager of the Ogoja Water Works. And he made my time there memorable. And he taught me one thing. He said, engineer, don't think that thing that you learned in the books, in the classroom, is different when you get to site. So listen to these technicians and to these technologists. Listen to them very well. They teach you a lot.
That is the man. And Mr. Ushaka, I almost call him engineer.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Mr. Fidelis Abomaye Ushaka for contribution to the development of engineering capacity in waterworks and signed Engineer Adekunle Mokuolu, FNSE, President.
The next person I'll call is Engineer Aminu Ibrahim, FNSE. Engineer Aminu Ibrahim was my boss in Federal Capital Development Authority. And he was the one that really made sure that, because in those days we have to attend meetings in Lagos, he would give me time off to attend those meetings. I sponsor it. So actually, it was the hidden strength. So thank you very much, sir.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Engineer Aminu Ibrahim, FNSE, for contribution to the growth of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, and signed Engineer Adekunle Mokuolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
The next person is Mr. James Abiodun Olotu. Mr. James Abiodun Olotu, for what he has achieved, you could just say he's an engineer, but he's not. He's a chartered accountant. But then, just last year, the immediate past president and council gave him the honorary fellowship of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I have an information that is absent. Something probably, is it? Somebody says, oh, sorry, sir. Maybe you just made it on the dot. You're welcome, sir. Maybe the flight was delayed or something. So, I have never seen a boss like him. I was working with him some time ago. I will send him a text message or an email at 1:30. Thinking that now I have my peace. Mr. Abiodun Olotu will reply me. By the time I wake up, he has replied me at about 4 or 4:30 a.m. I told him, sir, please enjoy sleep. That is his dedication. And under him, the NIPP, that's Nigerian Integrated Power Project, that was started actually by the administration of the distinguished guest of honor, Engineer Chief, Dr. Chief Olusegun Obasanjo. This man, Mr. James Olotu, made sure through dint hard work and tenacity to ensure that all the 10 power plants were completed, the transmission lines, 320 of them, completed, and over 294 injection power stations were completed. We need to showcase a Nigerian like this to know that we can get there.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Mr. James Abiodun Olotu for contribution to the development of power infrastructure in Nigeria. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu, FNSE. President, congratulations. I want people to know what we were saying on the side here. When the president of Nigeria Society of Engineers said all those power projects have been completed, I don't know whether you have seen the sign of completion in how you get power in your houses and in your industry. So I want to be sure that he was right. So I quietly whispered to Mr. Olotu. I said, how many of them have been completed? He said 85% of them. I said, if 85% of them have been completed, are they on stream feeding electricity into our homes? He said, most of them. Let's hope that all the 100% of them will be completed and all of them will be feeding power into our homes. Maybe we will see the change. Congratulations. My wife, Madam Abouni, she Emily. Well, okay, all right.
Thank you very much, sir. The next person is actually an individual that we need to showcase. At academician, engineer, Professor Oluwatoyin Ashiru, fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers for Distinguished Engineering Practice. This man has completed so many projects in oil and gas, and we believe he should be encouraged. Let us celebrate him. And he's an inventor with a patent of the United States of America.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Engineer Professor Oluwatoyin Ashiru, FNSE, for Distinguished Engineering Practice. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
The next person is to showcase the value of mentorship, proper mentorship. I've mentored some engineers in this country, but there's one of them that distinguished himself. This person, Tunde Olatayo Jimo, he, if you see those twin towers, the World Trade Center twin towers when you are coming from the airport opposite the church gate, he designed the curtain walls, the glass curtain walls in those twin towers, and he was made the project manager to fabricate and install those, you know, curtain wall, and the so-called expatriates, they were under him, they were subordinated to him. And so it was that because of his performance, the richest man in Africa, Alhaji Adigo Dangote, snatched him to be the project manager of his company's project in Apapa. Where is Tunde? Engineer Tunde is here. Oh, you're there already. Yes, I taught him to be very sharp.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Engineer Jimo Tunde Olatayo, FNSE, for your outstanding performance in engineering design and construction. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
There have been corporate bodies who are into engineering, production of engineering materials and products. One of them that we want to honor today is Lafarge Group for contributing to the improvement of health and safety in construction sites. For the first time in this country, a document of standards in health and safety has been produced. Is there any representative of Lafarge here? Okay.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Lafarge Group for contribution to improvement of health and safety in construction sites. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mokolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
The next company is Sahara Group for excellence in development of local capacity in engineering practice. Is there a representative of Sahara Group here? Okay. The next person, or the next corporate company rather, is Innocent Group. Innocent Group is dedicated to manufacturing everything that can have impact, engineering products that can have impact on Nigerians' well-being. Is there any representative from, is coming?
Okay. All right.
Thank you very much.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Innocent Group for excellence in development of local capacity in engineering practice. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mukolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
The next and the last, I hope the last. Corporate body that is being honored today is the Nigeria Liquefied Natural Gas Limited, NLNG. Today, if you go to their plants, they have 6 trains producing liquefied natural gas. There is no one single expatriate on that soil. Everything managed by Nigerians. Both administrative and technical issues are all managed by Nigerians completely. And this is very encouraging, and they need to be encouraged. Is there any representative of NLNG here to receive the award? Okay, it's coming now. Yes, they are. All of them Nigerians, now running the place.
The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Nigeria Liquefied Natural Gas Limited for excellence in development of local capacity in engineering practice, signed by Engineer Adekunle Mukolu, FNSE. President, congratulations.
The last and not the least, I would say, are my people. The building and construction skilled Artisans Association of Nigeria, BACSAN, is our strategy for ensuring that we use them for regulation and enforcement. They are partnering with Nigerian Center of Engineers to promise that nothing shall happen in construction industry if Nigerian engineers did not design it and ensure that the standards are maintained and that collapse of building in Nigeria will be a thing of the past. These are the people that we are partnering with as Nigerian Center of Engineers.
Let the camera catch all of you. The Nigerian Society of Engineers Special Presidential Award presented to Building and Construction Skilled Artisans Association of Nigeria for commitment to standards and safety enforcement in the construction industry. Signed, Engineer Adekunle Mukolu, FNSE, President. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Well, audience, thank you for your patience for them. Now, that is the last one. That's the last one. But then I'll quickly now call on the chest. Let them come. Baba has gone.
Please, sir, the BBHS are coming on stage. Can I invite the president of the Baptist Boys High School Boys Association to please come forward? You are not getting any award, but we need to recognize the school that made me. The distinguished guest of honor was from that school. I would have been his classmate, but God didn't make it to be like that.
Now, the president of Society of Nigeria Society of Engineers say we will sing the school anthem. When I was in school, in that school, there was no school anthem. So I will, if you see me opening my mouth, you know that I am not singing. All right.
So you know
the one, no. 1, 2, 3.
From Ekuya to Kishaje, Baptist Boys High School, we are proud of you. Through the process of metamorphosis, it's a blessing shining over Nigeria. Forever, never will we hold it. We will uphold all our great ideas. In which father shout hallelujah. For that day one, we will have the time.
Well, Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the difference between their generation and my generation is that they went to Shage Hill. I went to Egunya Hill. They are two different hills.
Thank you very much, sir.
We are here to celebrate and felicitate our very own engineer Adekunle Olumuewa Akanbi Mokuolu on his investiture as the 31st president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. We are very delighted that we have in our midst the greatest old boy of all time produced by our school. In fact, the greatest old boy of any secondary school in Nigeria. And I'm talking about none other than the former president, His Excellency, Chief Doctor Engineer Olusegun Obasanjo. We are glad, sir, that you're able to join us at this occasion. And that demonstrates the high esteem in which Chief Obasanjo holds the president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Okay, I should come that side.
Yes.
Oh, okay, sir. So, well, we are very proud. You have done us very proud by your elevation to this position, and we are very happy about that. We wish you God's guidance, the wisdom, the knowledge to discharge the duties of your office. Congratulations. Okay, this is coming from Club 6872, his class set when he was in school. They are presenting him with the award of the Man of the Year Award 2018, presented to Engineer Adekunle Olumuewa Mokuolu by President and members of Club 6872. In recognition of your outstanding achievements in the field of engineering in Nigeria and a pride to your alma mater, Baptist Boys High School, Abeokuta, congratulations. Okay? We have another one. This is from the Abuja branch of Baptist Boys High School, Abeokuta Old Boys Association. The president and members of the Abuja branch of the Baptist Boys High School Old Boys Association heartily congratulate our own engineer, Adekunle Olumuiwa Mokolu FNSC, on your investiture as the 31st president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. May your tenure witness unending progress within the society. Congratulations. Yes. Again. Congratulations.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. Okay.
We would like to invite Deaconess Abosede Oluyemisi Mukolu to join the president on the stage, while I invite NSC Abeokuta branch for their presentation, led by Engineer Ishola Abbas FNSC, Ilaro Engineers, led by Engineer Bat Odunlami FNSC. Please, let's come out very quickly and make our presentation to the president and his spouse. NSC Oshogbo branch, please get ready. Spouses Forum Lagos Zone, please get ready with your presentation. Abuja Spouses Forum, please also get ready. Please, let's quickly have your presentations, please.
We have to suspend this now. I'm sorry, you're already on the stage. Please, can you go back? We need to run with the time. Very sorry, please. No. Please, because of time. Yes. Let the special guest of honor. We apologize for that break in transmission. We have problems with protocol and time. The representative. Distinguished guest will speak. Okay. All right. Distinguished guest, sir. Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, Engineer Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, please, you have to come and make your speech now. Baba, please, can you? Then, after that,
the President of Nigeria Society of Engineers. You have made a long speech. I concur with a lot of what you have said. There are some part of your speech that I would have questioned if we have had the time. So what I now have to do is thank everybody for coming. Now, Kunle has brought me here for three reasons. One, because I'm an engineer. Two, because he's my son. And three, because he has shown tenacity. And I encourage, I salute your tenacity. On that note, it is now for the representative of the President of the Federal Republic to address us.
Thank you, sir.
Our highly respected former president, Your Excellency, the representative of the Senate President, and other members of the National Assembly, the Honorable Minister of Water Resources, and other members of the Federal Executive Council, the Deputy Governor of Ogun State, the President, past President, the 2018 Executive Committee, the Council of Fellows, Division and Branch Chairman of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, members and friends of the Society, Your Highnesses, our Royal Fathers, my Lords, spiritual and temporal, members of the press, and most distinguished ladies and gentlemen. We all know that His Excellency, the President of our great nation, President Muhammadu Buhari, holds engineers in very high regard. He sends his very warm greetings and wishes all Nigerian engineers a happy 2018. He would have loved to be here, but due to exigencies of duty, he asked me to represent him. It gives me great pleasure to be invited to this very important occasion of the investiture of Engineer Adekunle Mokuola as the 31st President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. The Nigerian Society of Engineers has proven to be a very useful partner of this present administration in our onerous task to develop our infrastructure as a launch pad of our economic development. It is with happiness that I specially commend the immediate past president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Otis Oliver Anyeji, for consolidating on the achievements of his predecessors, as well as the remarkable achievements in helping to reposition the engineering profession in the overall task of nation building. In the past 2 years, he provided outstanding leadership, which is very commendable. I specially congratulate the new president, Engineer Mokuola, who is an engineer of great repute and has contributed enormously to the development of our great nation. The federal government will continue to work with the Nigerian Society of Engineers for the purpose of sustainable economic diversification of the country in line with the Economic Recovery and Growth Plan 2017 to 2020. We expect our engineers to be in the vanguard of the scientific technological renaissance that we have inaugurated through innovative policies with the aim to spearhead the development of our nation. We believe very strongly that our engineers are well placed to assist in the realization of our numerous policy initiatives. The recent policy guidelines on design, planning, and execution of projects, programs, and contracts that have science, engineering, and technology components is particularly instructive. These policy guidelines, which have already been approved by the Federal Executive Council, are imbued with great revolutionary potentials that would be of great benefit to the generality of our engineers and other professionals in science and technology. I therefore challenge our engineers to jump on the bandwagon and seize the opportunities created by these guidelines for their own benefits as well as the benefit of our great nation. A presidential executive order will soon be signed and issued to commence the implementation of these guidelines. When this happens, I know that engineers will start and or maybe continue to dream dreams. And I want to assure you that this will offer opportunity to engineers, opportunity that we have never had since our independence. I call on you to utilize the enormous resources the country is endowed with to make Nigeria an industrial hub that will create new jobs, reduce poverty, and build a society of abundant wealth. Nations have become great by utilizing science and technology. We challenge you as our professionals to be the best you can so that our nation can be truly great. I again enjoin you to strive to be the best you can for the progress of our dear country. I believe you can do it if you cultivate the will to do so. And I want to assure the immediate past president that thinking that Nigerian engineers are in jail, this will no longer be the case. I thank you so much. May God bless our dear country, Nigeria.
Let's appreciate him a bit more, please. A round of applause for him. Thank you. Very quickly, we're going to take a couple of goodwill messages, and we're giving each of them 2 minutes. First off, we're having the president of Ghana Institute of Engineers, Engineer Mrs. Carolyn Bow Chedi.
The President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria is taking his leave. Also, the special guest of honor is also on his way back to Abeokuta We want to appreciate them for creating time to be here today for this investiture ceremony.
Very quickly, the goodwill message by the President of Ghana Institute of Engineers.
We want to appreciate the special guest of honor, the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari, FNSC, GCFR, ably represented by our own Honorable Minister of Science and Technology, His Excellency, Dr. Ogbonnaya Onu, FNSC, and also the guest of honor, the former President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Engineer Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, FNSC, GCFR. Want to appreciate them for coming today. While we are waiting for the President to come in for the goodwill message from the delegate from Ghana, we'd like to employ all the branches that have gifts for the President to please come forward with them and keep them just on the right side of the podium here. If you have gifts for the President, NSC Abeokuta Branch, Ilaro Engineers, Abuja Spouses, Lagos Zone Spouses, if you have gifts for the President, please, let's come forward with them. NSC Oshogbo Branch, NSC Ikeja Branch, please come forward with your gifts for the President while we wait for the President to come in for the goodwill messages. Thank you very much.
We also have a current desk at the foyer, so if you have to make inquiries or anything else, please go to the foyer. Thank you.
We also have gifts from NSC Port Harcourt Branch. Please come forward with your gifts. Let's put them on. Let's put them on the right side of the stage while we wait for the President to come in. Can we have light music while we wait for the President to come in? Light music, please. Thank you.
sorry to keep you waiting. Very quickly, we're having a goodwill message by the president of Ghana Institute of Engineers, Engineer Mrs. Carlin Bull Chadid.
I'd like to start by standing on the protocols that have already been established and say, President of Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Mokuolu, FNSC, congratulations on your election as President of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. We know that you are going to lead the society into greater heights. Let us say you have the support of the Ghana Institution of Engineers. We value the friendship between the two institutions, and not just at an institutional level, but also at the personal level. We thank you for the warm welcome that you have given to our delegation, and we trust that this collaboration will continue. And we'd like to make a presentation to you on this occasion, something to remember our friendship by. This presentation is something very typical of Ghana. As the wrapper shows, and there's one for you and one for your wife. Thank you.
Very quickly, we'll take another goodwill message from the Emir of Kano, who is represented by Alhaji Shehu Muhammad, Sir King Shan Kano. You have 2 minutes to do that, and your time starts now. Have our seats, please. We need a bit of order in the house. There's enough food to go around, everyone, so please kindly be seated. Thank you.
The President, Nigerian Society of Engineers, with your permission, I would like to stand on existing protocol and proceed with my message. When I came for the president's lecture some months ago, you gave me a personal invitation to deliver to His Highness Sir King Kano Muhammad Sanusi II. I promised at that time but unless there are pressing issues, I will make sure he attends this function taking place today. Unfortunately, however, when I get there, I discovered that his diary for these 3 days, 12, 13, and 14th of January 2018, were fully engaged. So on behalf of His Royal Highness, the Emir of Kano, I would like to congratulate the new president, the 31st president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, for taking over at a time when perhaps the Nigerian economy requires more hard work to make sure things begin to work as we have hoped. The theme for the conference today, Investiture for today, is Infrastructure Engineering for Unity and Progress in Nigeria. The students that demonstrated for us a few things during the drama session added one or two beautiful themes to this main theme. And this one is that I have hope, I have a dream, that's one. Second was there are solutions, and third was Nigerian engineers can do it. Now, I won't take this as a promise from the young ladies and boys on behalf of their colleagues all over Nigeria that this is a promise they are making to make Nigeria greater than they are finding it today. On this note, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to wish Engineer Adekunle Mwakulu and his council a successful tenure for the 2 years he will lead this society. And also wish everyone who has been here this afternoon, we've stayed too long, a safe journey and to our various destinations. Thank you for listening.
Last up, I'd like to call up for his goodwill message, the president of the Association of Professional Bodies of Nigeria. And he is Dr. Idris Omede, FNMA. Can we put our hands together for him as he comes up, please? Thank you.
Mr. President, the 31st President of NSE, all other protocols duly observed, I want on behalf of the Association of Professional Bodies of Nigeria congratulate you for this feat. You are not a new person in the field of professionalism, and you seem to have set the ball rolling from all that you want to do in the next 2 years. We want to pray that God give you the strength to carry out this responsibility. NSE is a very strong member of the Association of Professional Bodies of Nigeria. And I must say that it has given a lot of support to APBN, and we call on all the professional associations and institutes to do what NSE is doing to APBN. We believe as professionals, the key to development of our country, both in infrastructure and service delivery, lies in us. The politicians cannot do it without the professionals. And it's on that note that it is all our duty as professionals to join hands together to ensure that we advise the system and take the mantle of organizing and ensuring that strategically we make the professions and professionals have a major role and continue to have a major role in this country. NSE has, in the Council of APBN, the first Deputy President. In another few months from now, the first Deputy President, Engineer Ajibola, will be taking over from me. So NSE has a very major stake, and I want to congratulate NSE for it, and wish you and your executive a very, very successful tenure. Congratulations.
Very quickly, in 1 minute, I'll invite Builder Kenneth Unduka, FNIOB, President, Nigerian Institute of Builders, to the stage for his goodwill message in 1 minute. Thank you.
Good afternoon, all. Permit me to stand on all existing protocols.
I come here with goodwill message from Nigerian Institute of Building, Nigerian Society of Engineers, they are members of the built environment profession, and whatever they are doing, somehow, and most of the time, incidents with what other members of that profession, that industry, are doing. It is on that score that we felt that we should be here to give support, to give a friendly relationship towards what is being done today. Engineer Mokuolu has been with us, and we've been synergizing in many ways more than one to ensure that there is stability and there's progress, unity, and positive efforts towards solving the challenges of the built environment. I will conclude by saying that he has the support of Nigerian Institute of Building, and we hope that the synergy that has already been excited will go a long way to solving the problems that we have, especially as it relates to building collapse. Congratulations, Nigerian Society of Engineers, and thank you very much.
Thank you. Let's put our hands together for him as he leaves. We'll now take the vote of thanks by the Acting Executive Secretary of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Olataiwo. Please, let's put our hands together for him as he comes to give the vote of thanks.
The President, Nigerian Society of Engineers, Engineer Adekunle Olumuya Mokulu, FNSE, distinguished past presidents, all other protocols duly observed. I, on behalf of the Nigerian Society of Engineers and the entire Presidential Investiture Committee, and on my own behalf, extend very hearty votes of thanks to all speakers, especially the young lads from Christabel Private School, for granting time to attend this auspicious occasion today. Well, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, an event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheel started rolling weeks ago. It requires planning and a bird's eye for details. We have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very motivated and dedicated colleagues of the Nigerian Society of Engineers who know their job and are result-oriented. I cannot thank everyone enough for this involvement and their willingness to take on the completion task beyond their comfort zones. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, once again, I want to say that we are most grateful to all speakers, sponsors, donors, invited guests, and this beautiful you. We thank you for being with us this afternoon. It's been a great pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Just in 1 minute, you know the spouses are our women and their supporters. We would like to quickly invite all the spouses to be on stage with all the spouses, Abuja spouses, Lagos Zone spouses, to be on the stage with the Chairperson Spouses Forum to quickly make their presentation. We're about to close this program and we give them 1 minute to do that. Very quickly, please. 1 minute to do that very quickly. Make the presentation to the Chairperson Spouses Program, Deaconess Abosede Oluyemisi Mukolu. Can we quickly have the Lagos Zone spouses? Very quickly, please. Very, very quickly, please. Let's have them so that we can go.
On that note, that brings us to the end of this all-important occasion this afternoon. We'd like to thank you all for your time. And in closing, I'll humbly request that we all rise up as we say the closing prayer, which is going to be the second stanza of the national anthem. Can we rise as we take the second stanza of the national anthem? Thank you. O God of creation, direct our noble cause, guide our leaders right, help our youth the truth to know, in love and honesty to grow, and living just and true, great lofty heights attain, to build a nation where peace and justice shall reign. Amen. Thank you very much. We'll now have the national anthem, or remain standing.
Remain standing as the procession of the president leads the way out of the hall. Please let's remain standing as the procession of the president leaves the hall. Thank you very much. Please, the guests, please go to the banquet hall at the back of the stage. The invited guests, please go to the back of the stage where we have an arrangement for you, please. Thank you so very much.